Good morning or good afternoon. Thank you for your attendance. Yesterday, as you know, was a busy day. We had the swearing in at Government House of myself, the Deputy Prime Minister and the Treasurer. Of course, we also had Parliament. Last night, I met extensively with my colleagues, the Deputy Prime Minister, the Leader of the Government and the Senate, the Deputy Leader in the Senate, as well as the Treasurer, Chris Bowen. And we've been discussing at some length the composition of the ministry of this government. And those discussions, of course, have continued this morning. The new executive will be sworn in next Monday here in Canberra, subject, of course, to Her Excellency's availability. This morning, I've also spent a lot of time with the Secretary of the Department of Prime Minister and Cabinet, being briefed on current budget priorities, economic priorities, other policy priorities, and national security matters. And this afternoon, there will be a full briefing by the range of government officials beyond PM&C here in the Cabinet room, together with a briefing on national security by the full range of officials as well. So, we've had a few things on, as you would understand. Today, what I'd like to do is share with you the discussion I had with my Cabinet colleagues about 36 hours ago, and my caucus colleagues about 36 hours ago, about why I have elected to return to the Prime Ministership of Australia. I believe that this is important, and it's important that the nation is fully aware of why this change has occurred. Secondly, I also want today to share with you my overall approach to policy decision making by the government. And finally, I want to talk about the future of the National School Improvement Plan, better schools, better futures for our kids. On the first matter, there are three reasons that I sought to return to the leadership of this party. It is rare that a person is given a second opportunity to lead one of the major political parties of Australia. Mr. Howard was extended that opportunity. I've been extended that opportunity. And I regard it as a singular honour for that to have happened. First reason for my decision was that the government was on track for a catastrophic defeat at the upcoming elections. Not just a massive majority for Mr. Abbott in the lower house, but also a massive majority in the Senate as well, or at least a significant one. And were that to occur, then we would effectively have seen torn down so many of the reforms that this government, both under my prime ministership and Julia Gillard's prime ministership, we would have seen them simply disappear. Whether we're talking about the National Broadband Network, whether we're talking about trades training centres, whether we're talking about Medicare locals, whether we're talking about proper investment in our schools, whether we're talking about investment in basic things like urban rail projects, all these would simply be torn down were we to suffer such a catastrophic defeat, and had we lost in the Senate as well, who knows what would happen and what would have happened in terms of the future of the Fair Work Act, which affects penalty rates and working conditions and overtime for so many Australians. Some of these reforms, good reforms, have been Julia's, and I pay appropriate tribute to her work on the National School Improvement Program and her work on the National Disability Insurance Scheme. Some of these reforms, of course, date back to the period when I was Prime Minister after 2007. And some of these reforms were the joint work of both of us. My attitude was simply this: I could not stand idly by and allow all these good changes which have benefited millions of Australians to simply be thrown away in the event that we suffered such a catastrophic defeat at the election. Hence, it was time to put up my hand. The second reason is the mood I picked up across the Australian people over a long period of time is that whatever their politics, they want this election to at least provide them with the opportunity for a real choice. Many were saying to me and to my colleagues that they didn't feel as if they had a real choice, that they were being forced to choose Mr. Abbott when they didn't really want to. I believe that my return to the leadership of the Australian Labor Party and as Prime Minister of Australia provides the Australian people with that choice, a real policy choice for the next election and for Australia's future. And the third reason is that I want to make some policy changes. And those policy changes will be considered in due course by the Cabinet once it's sworn in. And over a period of time, these will be, of course, made public to you, the Australian media, and through you to the Australian people. These have been hard times in any political party. And various times in history, all parties have gone through such times. Then those parties come through. We intend to come through as well. What I have said privately is what I have said publicly. Any member of the ministry under Prime Minister Gillard who wishes to continue to work under my prime ministership will be welcome to do so. And I'm pleased and gratified that so many have chosen to do so.